Thank God for another opportunity to come before you at WLJC. I thank God that I'm part of it, that I can see signs and wonders happen here. You know, right on top of this Beattyville Hill, it's a lighthouse to the nursing homes, you know, to the hospitals. And there's so many people. We see a lot of things going on. We're up in the phone rooms. And, you know, Dottie, and we got a lot of requests come in that we pray for. And the live people that go out. And one great thing about it, you know, God is here to bless us, and we're going all over the world with this gospel that Jesus Christ is the Son of the Living God.
WLJC welcomes you to have church with us during the hour of harvest. Call in your prayer request or praise report now. The WLJC prayer team is standing by to talk and pray with you. We have some very special musical guests here this evening to share in song the good news of the gospel. So sit back, relax, sing along, and join in with us as we pray for you and the needs of all our viewing audience. Hour of Harvest is touching countless souls from the Appalachian Mountains to the Bluegrass region, across the nation, and around the world. Live from our studios in Beattyville, Kentucky, here is your host of the Hour of Harvest, Margaret Drake.
Well, good evening, everyone. We welcome you tonight to our WLJC Chapel service. We just thank God for you, and we appreciate you taking time out of your busy schedule. Summertime coming, and we just want you to join us tonight for some worship and praising the Lord, and magnifying God and lifting up His wonderful name. The Bible teaches us as the children of God, that's what our main purpose in life is. The main goal is, Revelation chapter 5, I believe it is, teaches us, for this reason we was born, and we was born to the praise and to the worship and to the glory of God. And so tonight we come to do that. And we want you to join in with us, and let's praise and magnify the Lord together. And so tonight I'm filling in. I'm Brother Fred Finley. I'm filling in tonight for Sister Margaret, giving her a break this evening. And so we just want you to join us tonight. We've got Brother Larry and his church is going to be singing for us. Tonight going to have some good music. Got a lot of folks upstairs tonight that will pray with you if you need somebody to pray with you and to believe God for you and to minister to you. They're upstairs tonight waiting to talk to you. And the thing about it, they all know what they're doing because they've done this for many years and they've paid many a prayer for many a person. And so tonight you can rest confident if you call, somebody up there knows how to touch the Lord. And so we're going to be going to the Lord in prayer, and then we're going to get into some scripture this evening, and our singers is going to come. But before we do tonight, we have a couple of prayer requests. One I got a call a while ago before I come down from a wonderful friend of mine, a great man of God, Brother Darrell Dooley. They've taken him to Winchester tonight. I think he's on the way to Winchester with him. Thought he'd had a stroke, and he's in pretty rough condition. So a couple of pastor friends of mine called me, is on the way down. So please remember Brother Darrell Dooley. Norma from Waco, she broke her hip, had three screws put in it, and we'll be going to rehab. Let's pray for her and that God would bless her and touch her. Also tonight, Louise Belfry, I think that is, needs prayer, has cancer, and she is from Menifee County. So we want to remember these needs tonight, that God would wonderfully bless those needs. Let's pray together tonight and just invite our hearts to be open to God. I don't think really we need to, as a child of God, we don't need to invite God to come in, because God is not a visitor. God takes up His abode on the inside of us. If we're filled with the Spirit of God and the knowledge and understanding of God, God lives in us all the time. What we want to do tonight is prepare our heart to go into the presence of God, which lives on the inside of us. Father, in the name of Jesus, we pray for these three requests that come in tonight, that there would be a healing. Father, touch their lives in a mighty manifestation. God, in the cases that it's life and death, we just speak life. We speak the life of God over these situations tonight. And Father, we pray for this precious lady that's going to rehab and has broke her hip. Father, we just pray for a speedy recovery. And God, we just pray you would meet all of these needs, that you would touch everyone here tonight. Anoint this singing. Anoint everything that is done for the glory of God. Bless all of those tonight that are watching. May this be a special appointed time. In Jesus' name. Amen. I got a few scripture. I'm going to read two scripture before we go over tonight to our singers. I'm going to read you some tonight from Ezra chapter 7. I'm going to start out reading in verse 9. I believe this ought to be the goal of all men and women of God that is in leadership all over this country, that is in leadership, that are leading people into the kingdom of God, preparing their hearts for their entry into heaven, and to give them a victorious walk in this world. Ezra, the man of God, the Bible said, for upon the first day of the week, or the first day of the month, began he to go from Babylon. And on the first day of the first month, came he to Jerusalem, according to the good hand of his God that was upon him. No matter where you can go from Babylon to Jerusalem or Jerusalem to Babylon. And God's blessings on you if you're the good man of God. And so he went from the cursed place to the blessed place. And here's what he did. For Ezra had prepared his heart to seek the law of the Lord. Tonight that's what we need to do, is prepare our heart for the Word of God. Prepare our heart that God's Word would just penetrate us and grow in us. Preparation, you don't go out and plant seed with that preparation. You've got to go out and plow up the sand, fertilize the ground. You've got to get rid of the weeds. You've got rid of all that stuff. And then your heart is prepared for the Word of God. And the reason why Ezra did that, the reason he did that was, and to do it and to teach Israel the statute and the judgments of God. Once you get in the kingdom of God and you learn the Word of God and begin to grow in the Word of God, what you need to do then is you need to teach those around you the laws and the statutes of the Lord so that they can have great success, so the promises of God will be fulfilled in their lives, not just in ours, but in all of those that follow us. All of those that listen to us and hear what we have to say. So let's prepare our hearts tonight for the Word, not only in the Bible, but in song, in testimony, and in every avenue that we have. Be like Ezra. Let's prepare our hearts tonight that we may feel our hearts, that we may feel others. Amen. Well, our guest tonight is a very familiar group, and that's the Full Gospel Evangelistic Ministry. They're from 400 Duckwire Road. And if you want to get a hold of them there, the church is in Irving, Kentucky. And it's 40336. Larry's phone number there is 606-723-0343. And you will get a hold of Brother Larry Collins. And they'll sure be able to help direct you in the direction of their church or whatever you would have need of. So this time, let's go over to the Evangelistic Ministries.
Praise the Lord. We're glad to be here tonight. Glory to God. And we just pray that we can be a blessing to you tonight. We can sing a song or maybe speak a word of encouragement for you tonight. Glory to God. We ask all of you that are watching tonight to pray for us tonight. Pray that God will use us for His glory. Hallelujah. That we could touch somebody's heart tonight. That someone would turn to the Lord. Ask forgiveness of their sin and receive Him as Lord and Savior. Glory to God. This first song we want to do is entitled Amazing Grace. We do it a little different. Listen to the words of it, and I pray it blesses you tonight. Thank you.
Hallelujah. 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 Good King of Kings and Lord of Lords. There is power.
Yes, there's power. Power in his name. Glory to God. King of kings and Lord of lords. Thank you, Jesus. This next song is entitled 4 Days Late. My daughter Bobby's going to sing that for us tonight. Glory to God. Thank you, Jesus.
The news came to Jesus. Please come fast. For Lazarus is sick. And without your help, he will not last. Mary and Martha watched their brother die. They waited for Jesus, but he did not come, and they wondered why. The death watch was over. He was buried 4 days.
Yes,
then somebody said, well, he'll soon be here. The Lord's on his way. Well, Martha ran to him, and then she cried. Lord, if you had been here, you could have healed him. He'd still be alive. But you're 4 days late, and no hope is gone. Lord, we don't understand why you waited so long. But his way is God's way. It's not yours or mine. And isn't it great? she said, Lord, you don't understand. He's been there 4 days. The gravestone was rolled back. And then Jesus cried.
Yes, thank you, Lord.
Lazarus come forth. Then somebody said, well, he's alive. He's alive. The same. He'll soon be here. He'll roll back the stone and he'll call out your name. 'Cause when he's 4 days late and no hope is gone, Lord, we don't understand why you
Praise the Lord. I love the Lord tonight. Love him with all my heart. Nothing with him. I love to sing this song. It says, shout out your name on the rooftops. Because I am yours, Jesus. I am yours.
Yes, Lord.
I thank God. December 18th, 1999, I gave my heart to the Lord. And he changed me. Took that stony heart away. Gave me a heart of flesh. Gave me a heart for love and compassion. If you're out there tonight and you need to touch from the Lord, all you got to do is call out the name of Jesus. Just call on the name of Jesus. I love that wonderful name, the name of Jesus. No greater name given among men. That name is what saves you, though. No other way to the God the Father than through the mighty name of Jesus. We praise you. I don't send this song out to Cousin Trish, she said, because I just love to hear you sing that song.
Hallelujah.
I don't consider myself much a singer, but I sure love the Lord. I know that.
Here I am before you, falling in love, seeking your truth, knowing that your perfect grace has brought me to this place. Because of you, I freely live my life to you, oh God, I give. So I stand before you, God, lift my voice, 'cause you set me free. Your name from the rooftops I proclaim, Jesus, I am yours. I am yours. All the good done for me, lift up my hands, all to see. You're the only one that brings me to my knees. Across the earth, the beauty of the holy word. So I kneel before you, God. Lift my hands, 'cause you say.
You know, in the book of Isaiah, Isaiah spoke of a vision. Hallelujah. We're going to sing that vision to you tonight. Glory to God. In that vision, he saw the Lord high and lifted up. And the scripture says that his train filled the temple. Glory to God. Hallelujah. And we know tonight that he's never lost a battle, nor will he ever lose a battle. Glory to God. He's always victorious. Hallelujah. And if you're on his side tonight and he's on your side, glory to God. If you're in him and he's in you, glory to God. No matter what the enemy comes at you with, hallelujah, you can have victory over that tonight. Glory to God through Jesus. So listen to the words of this song tonight. Let it bless you. I see the Lord and his train fill the temple. I see the Lord. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. We're going to let our young people come and sing a couple songs for you tonight. I'm so glad to have them with us tonight. Hallelujah. We're going to change a couple of instruments real quick. Stephanie, I want you to stay with them. You're their youth pastor, and I want you to kind of introduce some glory to God to her people tonight. And we're so proud of our young people, what God is doing in them. Hallelujah. How they've progressed and they've come along. And I just thank the Lord for them tonight. Glory to God. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Yes, Lord. Thank you, Lord.
Everybody seat wide. Praise the Lord. We'll start over here on the guitar. This is Caleb. Caleb's 14 years old. He's my son. Back here on the keyboard, we got Faith Elizabeth. She's 14. And standing beside her is Lindsay Michelle, and she is their music worship leader. And on the drums is my youngest son, Cameron. And over here to my side is Scott, and he's on the bass. And back here is Christina on the guitar, and she helps Lindsay lead them with the music. So I hope you enjoy them. Y'all pray for them that God continues to use them, because we've seen a lot of growth in these young people. Every last Saturday of the month, we have a youth meeting, and they do the music for us. And then they ask for another night, so we're doing every second Wednesday of the month is going to be our young people doing the worship. So y'all go ahead.
Away, I give myself away, so
Praise the Lord for what he's doing in these young people. You know, they could be anywhere in the world tonight, but they chose to work for Jesus tonight, and I thank God for that. Yes. And I pray that he just keeps using them more and more and opens more doors for them.
You unravel me with a melody. You surround me with a song of deliverance from my enemies, till all
chosen me, love has called my name. I've been born again to your family, your blood flows through my veins. I'm no longer
so I could walk right through it. child of God. And I'm no longer a slave to fear, but I am a child of God. I'm no longer a slave to fear, though I am a child of God.
Amen. That's a wonderful job. Wonderful job. Amen. While they're getting them a break tonight, I know it's getting hot in their little slides. We will read some names of those that's called in tonight. A lot of people calling in. A lot of people need prayer. Here's Price and Amanda from Madison County. Amanda fell and broke her hip, and she's in rehab, and she needs prayer. David from over in Floyd County tonight has cancer and needs prayer there. I believe that's Billy from McKee is going blind, and Billy really needs a touch from the Lord this evening. Donna from Corbin needs prayer for arthritis, and we want to remember that for her tonight. Also tonight, all my friends, they said, in Harlan, Cumberland, and all of those places tonight, in Pikeville, and Whitesburg, Estill County, Richmond, and all over the place just needs prayer this evening. Here tonight, Nancy from Flemingsburg went to the doctor today and got a bad report, and we definitely want to be praying for her this evening. Here's Horace and Mary from Estill County needs God to touch them in their bodies this evening. Mary from in Fayette County is battling with the flu. Here's Kitty from Beattyville battling with drugs tonight. I also want to be praying tonight for Lisa and her family. From Rockcastle County, they need prayer this evening. Here's Tracy and family from Madison County. Please remember them in prayer. Tiffany and Corey tonight from Madison County, they're in the need of prayer. Also tonight, Becky and Peanut from Breathitt, pray for all of their family this evening. Also this evening, we want to remember Tommy and Becky from Harlan County. Pray for all of those other family members this evening. Brenda and Crystal from Partridge tonight needs the healing. Family needs salvation. So we definitely want to remember those needs this evening. Eddie and Debbie tonight from Powell County needs the healing. Jackie and Tanya from Clark County, pray for all of their family. Sizemore family tonight needs salvation. Mary tonight, called in by Debbie from Estill County, pray for all of her family. Debbie tonight from Estill County, that's Debbie Rose, and they're from Estill County, and they some of their family needs salvation and also needs a healing. Snowden tonight from Estill County has a bad toothache. Vedas Abney tonight from Estill needs a touch from the Lord. Christina and Stephen needs a touch from the Lord and their family this evening. Aunt Merlin needs a touch from the Lord. Here's David, Debbie, and Bill. Tonight needs a touch from God. Pray for Alma, Charlie, David, Debbie, April, and boys, niece, nephews, and all of their family. Also tonight needs Sister Lynn Daniels needs prayer tonight for a speedily recover. Sister Lynn's missed a lot up there on those phones while she's in recovery. So please pray for Lynn Daniels tonight. Sandy and Danny and their children tonight, and a lot of them are in need of salvation. Here's Lisa tonight wanting salvation for her son. Also tonight, Cameron from Puri. Cameron is a junior in high school and needs salvation, and other family members. Here's Rachel from Madison. Please pray for them. Andrew and Mary tonight from Clark County. Andrew is in the UK. We'll be having surgery on Friday. Please pray for Andrew. Here's Christopher, April, and kids tonight from El Paso, Texas. Please remember them in prayer. Terry and Vicky tonight. Call them Joyce from Fayette County. They need a touch from God. Don and Joyce tonight from Pike County. Don is suffering from congestive heart failure, so please remember them. Doug and Christina tonight from Mount Vernon needs God's help and also prayer because they had a house fire. So we want to remember all of those needs this evening. Let me get these in this evening. We've had one called in tonight. Prayer here for Alfie Clevenger. Amen. So we want to remember Alfie Clevenger tonight from over in Mount Sterling. And she just needs the touch of the Lord, and pray for her children and all of these things going on. Alfie is a faithful caller in tonight. Here is Glory Land Baptist Church tonight, and that's down in Madison County. And they've got Robert and Dorothy and Hargis and all these guys that's got cancer. They've got some with got a whole list here that we're going to pray over. So we want to just remember every name there from Glory Land Baptist Church. Brother Rogers got every one of their names down there, and we want to remember them. Here's Larry tonight from West Liberty. Blood clots in his legs. Here's Sharon tonight. Sore in her chest and back. WLJC tonight. Well, Esther Sizemore called in a pledge from Lee County tonight. $20, you know. And so I think that's in honor of Neville Gabbert. Phyllis tonight from over in London. Pray for the needs that he has in his life. Bill tonight from Fayette County. Bill is having a PET scan tomorrow for cancer. So let's remember Bill. Here is Louise from Wolf County, called in for herself tonight. Has been taking chemo, and she needs prayer. Bethel tonight and her husband from Knott County. Preacher Bethel has flu. Dorothy has bronchitis, and they all need a healing from the Lord tonight. Here's Iva from over in Fayette County, has had two heart attacks, and pray for them, and their son needs a touch from God, and Robin, and got quite a few names there that needs a touch from God. And tonight, Alfie Clevenger, I believe I read Alfie's a minute ago. So anyway, we got our name request picked up tonight. Remember, someone's up there to pray with you. If you are in need of prayer, just pick up that phone tonight, call, and believe God, that God's going to do something in your life. You know, faith is not a hard thing, and belief is not a hard thing. D.L. Moody once said many years ago, faith and belief is just doing. You know, and we don't have to exercise anything hardly mentally to do. We just get up and do it. And so to believe God, you just do it. To have faith in God, you just do it. You believe God and you walk like God has done it for you. And so that's where faith lies. It lies in the doing. The Bible says, show me your faith without your doing or without your work. I'll show you my faith by my works or by my doings. And it's not necessarily talking about doing great and mighty feats in this world, but it's just talking about living out your faith, walking out your faith, walking out your belief system, walking out what you're asking God to do. Many years ago when I first started preaching, I had this wonderful old Baptist preacher. He told me, he said, "Brother Fred, when you believe God, if you're believing God for some milk, start packing your milk pail around." And so I've always kept that in the back of my mind. And so tonight, if you're believing God for something, remember, it's God's good pleasure to give to His children all of the needs that they have need of in their life. And so tonight, if you believe God, if you're looking for God to do something in your life, spend some time in prayer over it. Find you some scripture in the Word of God that will back up what you're believing. And I've seen so many people in my time that has battled cancer, that's overcome cancer, that's overcome being at death's door, because somewhere along in the night season, or they would come across it in the Word of God, God would give them a scripture to stand on. And one lady in my church had cancer, and it had about eat her up. And so she found in the New Testament, Old Testament, where God told the children of Israel, "You shall live and not die." And so she laid a hold of that scripture, but she added something to it. Now I know people say, "You don't supposed to add to the scripture," but here's what she would pray. She would pray, "I shall live and not die. Cancer shall die in me and not live." So God's alive in us, and God is working. And all we got to do is just believe God. Just stretch your faith a little bit. Just reach out to the point of doing. You know, when you reach so far that you can't touch it, one step will get you to where it is. If you reach so far that you can't feel it, take one step. And I know a young lady got saved a couple of weekends in a church, and she was telling me over the weekend, and she said, "I got up and took one step, and it just seemed like He carried me the rest of the way." And so that's how God is. If you'll make an effort to get to Him, God will make an effort to get to you. And so anytime our singers get ready, they want to sing some more, they can come back, and we'll get back to the singing tonight some. But remember, faith works, faith operates. Faith is not a dead issue. Faith is not a noun. Faithfulness is a noun. Faith is a verb. And what faith does, it's always in action. Believing is a continual process. Believing is not a belief that you believe one time, but believing is a process. It's an act, and it's a walk, and it's a doing. So when you have someone, when they pray for you up there tonight on the phones, or we pray at the end of this service, what we want you to do is just go ahead and just reach out and start doing like God has already touched you and God has already ministered you. Amen. So we're waiting to hear from your call. We're going back over to the singers tonight. And so you call in and they'll sing the glory down. Brother Larry.
Praise the Lord. Thank you, brother. Glory to God. Hallelujah. We love singing for the Lord. Glory to God. Pray that we've already been a blessing to you tonight. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Continue to pray for us. Hallelujah. Those of you that pray and those that are watching tonight, and if you don't have a personal relationship with Jesus Christ, we'd like to invite you right now, glory to God, to call up on Him and say, "Lord, here I am. I'm a sinner. Would you come into my life? Forgive me of my sin. Cleanse me and make me whole." Glory to God. I promise you, He'll meet you there, and He'll change your life. Glory to God. Hallelujah.
Take my name, oh Lord.
hear that trumpet sound. I'm gonna get up out of the ground. There ain't no grave. Gonna hold my body down. No, there ain't no
sound, going to get up out of the ground. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Here's a lot of people's favorite. Brother Ernie's going to clap his hands. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. He can't get away without singing this song. Praise God. Get in here and clap your hands with us, Brother Fred. Glory to God. Hallelujah.
When I first found us on its way, my nights turn to day, yeah. And my friends don't understand why I sing and clap my hands. Clap your hands, clap your hands. Everybody clap your hands. Clap your hands, clap your hands.
Clap your hands. Clap our hands.
Clap your hands, clap your hands.
Well, glory to God, I'm clapping my hands.
With the devil in the eye, and clap your hands.
Praise the name of Jesus, yeah. I'll clap my hands.
Clap your hands, clap your hands. Everybody clap your hands. When the end comes by blood,
yeah.
I tell him I'm covered by the blood.
Yes, Lord.
With my praise, I take my stand. I sing and shout and clap my hands. Clap your hands, clap your hands. Everybody clap your hands.
That devil's gotta go.
Let him know you're holding God's hand.
Oh, let him know you're holding God's hand.
You're not gonna worry, gonna clap your hands.
You're not gonna worry, gonna clap my hands.
Clap your hands, clap your hands.
Yes, we love you, Lord.
Everybody clap your hands. Clap your hands, clap your hands.
Yes, come on, people, clap your hands.
Everybody clap your hands.
Let's praise his name. Let's clap our hands.
Clap your hands, clap your hands.
We'll go with your God. I'm Excuse me. Praise the Lord.
This next song that Pastor's going to sing, I believe we're going to dedicate that song to Walter and Virgie Turner.
Hallelujah. Y'all pray for me. I've been battling these allergies and these. Praise God. My pastor, Gordon Little, always loved this song. Glory to God. Thank you, Jesus. I believe he walked on water in the midst of the sea. Yes, I believe. I believe. I believe he healed the sick and he set the captives free. Yes, I believe. Yes, I believe. I believe in the Father. I believe. I believe in that precious Holy Ghost. I believe you sent your Son to earth to die on a tree. Yes, I believe. Yes, I believe. I believe he cleansed the leper, preach the gospel to the poor. Yes, I believe. Yes, I believe. And I believe he said, just trust in me and live forevermore. Yes, I believe. Yes, I to the tomb, raised Lazarus from the dead. Yes, I believe. Yes, I believe. I believe in the Father. I believe in the Son. I believe in that precious Holy Ghost. I believe
precious Holy Ghost. I believe you sent your Son to earth to die on a tree. Yes, I believe. Yes, I believe.
Feel the Lord move upon you. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you for your love, for your mercy. Next song's entitled Even If. Glory to God. Hallelujah. You know, Brother Fred, if he never blesses me again, he's still my Savior. He's still my Lord. He's still my Master. If he never heals me again, he's still my Lord. He's still my Master. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Listen to the words of this song tonight. She sings it. Let it bless you.
This is sometimes you win some, sometimes you lose some, and right now I'm losing, babe. I stood on this stage night after night, reminding the broken it'll be alright, but right now, I just can't. It's easy to sing when there's nothing to bring me down. But what will I say when I'm held to the flame like I am? Right. I know you're able and I know you can save through the fire with your mighty hand. But even if you don't, my hope is you alone. You say it only takes a little faith. Faith is all I have right now. God, when you choose to leave mountains unmovable, oh, give me the strength to be able to sing. It is well with my soul. I know you're able and I through the fire with your mighty hand. Even if you don't, my hope is you alone. I know the sorrow and I know the hurt would all go away if you just say the word. But even if you don't, my hope is you alone. You've been faithful, you've been good all my days. Jesus, I will cling to you, come what may, 'cause I know I know.
soul. It is well, it is well with my soul.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord.
I want to praise the Lord for being here tonight, and I praise the Lord for what he's doing in my life. I praise him from where he's brought me from, and I praise him from where he's taken me to. And I praise him for my daughter back there on the that's playing the keyboard. I love her with all my heart, and she's a mini-me. She's got an attitude sometimes, but she loves the Lord, and that's all that matters. So I praise the Lord for her, too.
Words of this song. Brother Ernie took it and changed the words around. Glory to God. The Lord, he was in one of them places and he heard it, and it was an old song that he used to listen to when he was lost, and he asked the Lord to give him some words to that song, and that's what the Lord done. So listen to the words.
What should we say? We're not coming down.
pray. You are holy, Lord, King of kings, Lord of lords, ruler of all things, Jehovah Jireh, Jehovah Nissi, eternal Savior, you're the Prince of Peace. We are here, Lord. We are here. We will not be moved. We will not fear. What must we do, Lord? What shall we say? We're not coming down, Lord. Came here to pray. Can't you see? Jesus died for you and me. Can't you see? Can't you see? Jesus died for you and me. Pray through. We're not coming down, Lord, till we hear from you.
Don't wait till the battle is over. Don't wait till the victory's won. You just remember whatever God promised. Well, it's yours, it's already done. So don't wait,
don't wait.
No, don't wait. Shout now. Shout now.
Shout now.
Shout now.
Shout now.
Don't you worry. Oh, cause Jesus, he never fails. So don't wait.
Don't wait.
No, don't wait.
Don't wait.
Shout now.
Hey.
Shout now.
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 Oh, shout now.
doctor says you won't get well. Oh, no, now don't you fret, now don't you worry. Oh, my Jesus, he never fails. So don't wait.
Don't wait.
No, don't wait.
Hallelujah. We want our young people to come back and do a couple more songs before we end it tonight. Praise God. Well, we hope we've been a blessing to you. Glory to God. And remember, if you're out there tonight and you don't know Jesus, now would be a great time to just call upon him and say, Lord, here I am. I'm in need of a Savior. You see, he already knows our hearts. Glory to God. He knows everything about us before we ever say a word. Glory to God. And all you got to do is call upon him. Don't take a fancy prayer. He knows your heart. Whenever you surrender yourself, glory to God, he'll come into you, cleanse you, and make you whole. Praise God.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus.
Out of the shadows, bound for the gallows, a dead man walking, till love came calling. So rise up,
rise up,
rise up,
rise up.
6 feet under, I thought it was over. An answer to prayer, the voice of a Savior. So rise up,
rise up,
rise up,
rise up.
Oh, at once I came alive. This beating heart, these open eyes, the grave let go, darkness should have known. You're still rolling stones. You're still rolling stones.
Oh,
middle of the night. I'm praying for assurance everything's gonna be alright. But Lord, I see another battle. Yes, it's out in front of me. I'm afraid I won't be able, and I'll go down in defeat. But he said I walks on the water, and I calm the raging sea. Well, I spoke to the winds, well, it rushed, and I gave you peace. Didn't I run to your rescue? Didn't I hear you when you called? And I walked right beside you just so you wouldn't fall. Didn't I leave all of heaven just to die for your sins? Well, I searched until I found you, and I'd do it all again.
He said, do you remember where I brought you from? Just take a look behind you at how far you have come. And every time that you asked me, didn't I?
Said my bills are coming to Lord, and 6 days is not that long. And then she hears a voice so still and low. He says, I'll move like that before, and I'll do this little thing, and I'll give you so much more. But he said, I walked on the water, and I calmed the rage. I spoke to the wind, well, it hushed, and I gave you peace. Didn't I run to your rescue? Didn't I hear you when you called? And I walked right beside you just so you wouldn't fall. Didn't I leave all of heaven just to die for your sins? Well, I searched until I found you, and I'd do it all again. Well, I searched until I found you, and I'd do it all
again. Hungry, we are hungry, we are hungry for more of you. We are thirsty, oh Jesus, we are thirsty for more of you. are hungry, we are hungry, we are hungry for more of you. We are thirsty, oh Jesus, we are thirsty for more of you. And more of you.
Amen. Full Gospel Evangelistic Ministry from over in Irvine, Kentucky. And if you want to get a hold of them, you get a hold of Brother Larry Collins at 606-723-0342. They did a wonderful job tonight, and we appreciate them coming tonight and being a part of this service. And we hope you have enjoyed them and believe that you have. I'm going to go over and I let Brother Cecil read a few pledges and say whatever on his heart this evening. And Cecil's been up there answering them phones. And so what's on your mind, Brother Cecil?
You know, Brother Fred, there have been a lot of them answering phones tonight. But you know, we hear a lot of problems. And we get a lot of prayer requests. But you know, when it comes right down to it, Brother Fred, I know we're in trouble in America, but you know, I know who wins. Uh-huh. You go to Revelation, the end of it, and you know the devil loses at the end. We know who the winner is. Brother Dave throwed that at me as I was coming down the stairs. But you know, his right here in 2 Corinthians chapter 12, verse 9, his grace is sufficient for every one of us. You know, Paul had a lot of problems, Ernie. He had a lot of problems in this life. And he knew too much, friend. You know, Paul knew too much. I know this man 14 years ago didn't know if it's in the body or out. But he's called up to the third heaven. You can say whoever you want it to be, but that's okay. That's okay. He knew too much. And I just want to know enough, don't you? I feel, you know, them young people, they should excite the world out there. But one thing about it, you know, His grace is sufficient for every one of us. I thank God, you know, Brother Fred, as we all pray for WLJC, and people still calling in praying for it, that this station just keeps going. And I feel the goodness and the power, because a lot of people right here is from Pike County, a nephew with liver cancer, and other friends. And right here's Peggy from Fayette County. You know, a lot of problems going on, a lot of mental stuff as they write down. You know, we don't quote everything people write, but one thing about a lot of suicidal in Lexington, a lot of shootings going on. But wait a minute, remember one thing, His grace is sufficient for every one of us. And Fred was telling me about some great revivals going on in the Appalachian Mountain. I thank God for men that still, as me and Fred was talking about, preachers on fire. I thank God for the ones with that Holy Ghost fire that can really reach out. I won't get started, Fred, believe me. And right here's one from Floyd County. Both of them have cancer. I believe we got a God big enough to stop that cancer.
Amen.
I believe we got a God big enough that we ask, we shall receive. Yeah, I can get excited real quick. Why? Hey, the devil gets excited, Fred. And his people does, but whoa, glory to God. When he knows he's a loser and his days is short, Brother Fred, you know what? I know a man called Jesus can get it all done. You know, I was telling them upstairs there a while ago, these young people excite me. Praise God. Let them step out for Jesus. He said he's going to pour his spirit down on all flesh, didn't he? Yeah. Young people, glory to God. You got to be prophesied. And right here is Linda from Whitley County. You know, needs prayer, so weak. You know what, folks? Listen to me. I'll tell you what, it may get this, the food may be have everything in the world in it, but hey, remember His grace is sufficient for us. Remember one thing. Hey, whatever He blesses is what, friend? clean.
Amen. And right here, Jacob. I like that name, don't you? Mm-hmm. Jacob and Shannon. 90-year-old. Amen. Praise God. I want God to move on these people. Here's Jeff from Breathitt County. Jeff's got a lot of heart problems, but one thing about it, here's another one from Floyd County and Perry County. Broke her hip. That's what we've been praying for. Amanda. Amanda, you're watching tonight, you and Pierce. We're asking a blessing upon him. Andy, you're over in UK. And also, Robert Johnson's over at UK. Folks, listen, that's the reason we want everybody. We don't want to play games with the airways of WLJC because the hospital's got it tuned in, the nursing home's got it tuned in, and you know what? Hey, let God have His way in your life. And you know, somebody out there, Brother Fred, is wanting a movement of God, and I can feel that movement coming through that air. I know you got something to read. Go ahead.
Just a few. Then
I'll fire back up. Glory
okay.
to God.
Okay. I ain't pouring no water on your fire now. Goldie and Earl from Montgomery County, arthritis, and they need a touch from God.
Yes, Lord.
Laura from Moorhead tonight needs a touch from the Lord. Anthony from Powell County needs a touch from God. Battling drugs and stuff of that nature. James needs prayer tonight. I think it's Loretta needs a touch from the Lord from Powell County this evening. We have Miss Cavanaugh. Well, bless her heart. I haven't heard Miss Cavanaugh in a while. So It's so good here for her in, down in Madison County. Needs prayer for her health tonight. Buddy from Breathitt County needs prayer for pain in his body and Free Union Church in Adair County said about all of them are sick that are in their church. Also needs prayer for their community. Carrie, Wolf County needs a touch from God. Two boys from Breathitt County, Owen Louise from Breathitt County. Grandkids from Harlan County. Two boys from Lincoln County.
Yes, mighty God.
Paul from Breathitt County tonight needs a touch. Terry from Madison County. Here's Debbie from tonight. Thursday, starting radiation on Thursday, needs a touch from God. Uncle Larry tonight from Macquarie County got cancer.
Bless
the Lord.
They
want to pray for him. Here's Joyce tonight from Macquarie County in a need from touch from God. Jordan tonight, mother called in from Macquarie County. He's a battling seizures tonight, veterans. And let's see, Amy and Mom, and they need a touch from God. They're from down in Powell County. And the Harlan and their family, Dale and his family tonight, want to be praying for them. Angie and their family tonight, want to remember them. And Wanda tonight, battling from Clay County. Linda from Clay County, battling with a stroke tonight.
Yes, Lord.
Earl from Laurel County needs a touch from God. And here's Ollie from Floyd County, needs prayer also this evening. So I'll let Cecil share some scripture with us here for just a minute, and then we'll pray for all of these needs tonight.
Yes, mighty Lord. You know, Brother Fred, I love the scripture of God because we're begotten by the Word. But you know, we got to have something mixed with this Word. As me and the Brother Roger was talking a while ago, you know, this Word is just a book. But you put the Spirit of God with it, honey, and mix it up. And glory to God, I believe it works. I believe it works. We've been praying for people. It's exciting, as Dave said, you know, it's exciting to see one more soul come to the Lord. You know, the Bible, we open it up, and we can open it up anywhere. And it said in John 14, let not your hearts be troubled, believe in God. Also believe, in me, in my Father's house. Think about this. You know what? This is a book. And we bring. I have people bring all kind of conversations up to me. No, I don't believe in Buddha. No, I don't. I don't believe in no pagans. No. But now that's their business, and you can't get in it. It's everybody's business what they believe in. But I believe in a risen Savior, friend. We agree on that. Drop everything else and believe He walked here. Believe, He died on that cross. He rose again, and He's alive with us. Right now. Amen. And you know what? That's exciting to know that this Word is still alive. In my Father's house
are many mansions. If it were not so, I would have told you. I go to prepare a place. You know what? I'm getting ready, baby. Right. Yes, sir. That place he went to prepare for me, you hear me. People would listen to this word more. It's not in the music. It's not in the singing. It's in the power and might of an almighty God. Amen. Well, I can't help it how people believe, but you know what? The old prophets here, all through this word, believed in a risen Savior.
Yeah.
You know, in the Old Testament, he hadn't rose, but he was still alive, and they prepared for his way. And I believe he set us free. I feel free tonight because I'm reading a little bit more here. And if I go and prepare a place for you, listen now, I will come again and receive you unto myself, and where I am, there you may be also. Awesome. Ain't that something, Fred? I know you have to love me because to get to heaven, amen. You quoted at me, but you know we're going to be there together.
Oh yeah.
And I believe we'll know a lot of stuff and a lot of people, and there'll be people there that we didn't think was going to make it, probably.
That's
too.
Right.
But praise God! Hey, we're in trouble out there, but we're really not. You know the born again believers. Hey, are you a born-again believer tonight? Search yourself and search the Scripture. See if you have eternal life, right? He said, ask him, we shall receive. Seek him, we shall find. Listen out there. There's some people I know that's out there right now. Listen to these young people. Listen to this singing. But if you've never, never, repented and asked God to come into your heart and save you, you're lost. The Bible said. The Bible said it now. I'm going to clear myself with the word. But he said, hey, if you're out there and you're lost tonight, say, Lord, forgive me. Lord, I've sinned. I'm lost. Come into my heart and save me.
Pray for us.
And I believe he'll get it done. Help us pray. Put your hands this way tonight. And I know there's a lot of old saints out there that wants to pray. And all the people in here, the people out there, I see Brother Larry got his hand this way. Fathers, we come in your mighty loving name. I feel your goodness and your power. I feel the love that you have. Thank you, Lord, for the music. But most of all, thank you for your spirit being here tonight. I feel the power and the goodness, and there are many people crying out and wrote their names down here. Brother Fred has read them. And I feel that anointing. I feel that power for this station and many others. I thank you for these young people, Lord. Lord, let many more come in and lift your name up. Glory to God. That's what we're doing. We're glorifying you tonight, giving you praise, glory, and honor in Jesus' mighty name. Through your spirit we pray. Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen. Praise God. Hallelujah. Well, you got anything else to add to that?
Oh, Fred, I've got so much it's bubbling over. Glory to God. And, you know, we're lifting up all the pastors, Brother Larry. And it's exciting to see pastors come in here like Brother Dave and many others, you and Brother Wayne and Brother Larry, coming in answering phones. Because there's one more out there that's lost and undone without Christ. And you know what? We are pastors. I've been doing this 35 years. But I'm a friend to an almighty God and a servant to the people.
Amen.
Ain't that what he says? And you know, I'm lifting up our country. I'm lifting up our farming tonight. And doctors, we need to pray for them doctors. Not put them down, pray, lift them up. You know, the policemen today, it's pitiful out there what's happening. You know, as we set up here tonight, there's so much going on in our little communities around us. Glory to God. And Fred, I'm running out of time. Hallelujah. Yeah. I appreciate you.
He's running out of time, a long time before he runs out of words. That's called the call of the ministry. Amen. When a preacher runs out of words before he does time, he's got a problem. So we appreciate Brother Cecil tonight coming down and sharing with us. And we appreciate all these singers tonight.
Yes, mighty Lord.
They was laboring in the gospel, and that's what you
Amen.
Call laboring for God. The Bible says that Come we're on. To give him our all.
Yeah.
And all in all, the Bible says we'll give him our mind, our soul, our spirit, our body. Mm-hmm. All of that belongs to Jesus.
Amen.
And then the Bible goes on to say, as Buddy preached Sunday night at our church, the day you give me your whole heart.
Uh-huh.
The whole heart. And that's when you're not ashamed of him. That's when you're not ashamed of his testimonies.
Amen.
That's when you're not ashamed of his glory and witness and power and all of that wonderful
stuff.
That's
right. Stuff. Amen.
Amen. So it's been a wonderful night. We appreciate you being here. All of you that called in, your names have been prayed over at least
twice
tonight. And those names will stay upstairs, and we pray for them all year long. They're
Amen.
Up there. And so we thank you for joining us. We hope you have a wonderful evening. And remember, God loves you. And spring is coming forth.
Yeah.
As nature brings forth new life, we are to get new life as Christians.
Yeah.
And get on far for God and just see what we can accomplish
Amen.
This summer.
Thank you, Lord.
And God's doing a lot of things. A lot of things is happening all over our countryside. It's real exciting.
Yeah.
And so we want you guys to be a part of that. Be in prayer and be in prayer for the TV station that we can bring forth good programming, that a lot of people be saved and born again. And so that's what we want to see happen.
Amen.
So what we're going to do, I guess, is just turn it back over tonight. And so you remember, God loves you. We do too. And we'll see you tomorrow night. Someone will be here looking for you. Good night, and may God bless.
God bless you.
Thank you for being a part of the Hour of Harvest. We hope you get a blessing every time you watch. This program is available for download on your computer or mobile device at www.wljc.com. DVD copies of this program are also available for your contribution of $15 or more. The WLJC programs, including the Hour of Harvest, are brought to you through your contributions of support. All contributions made to WLJC are eligible for income tax deduction. Thanks to all who support us. Without you, our programming would not be possible. If you would like to join our mailing list to receive our free monthly newsletter to keep you informed about what is happening at WLJC, along with our monthly musical guest schedule, call us or write to WLJC, P.O. Box Y, Beattyville, Kentucky, 41311. Want to hear from us faster? Join our email mailing list. You can sign up at WLJC.com. It's easy and it's free. May God bless you. P.O. Box Y, Beattyville, Kentucky, 41311. Want to hear from us faster? Join our email mailing list. You can sign up at WLJC.com. It's easy and it's free. May God bless you.
And it's a great day.